All right, guys, this is Kelly again, Southwest Blinds and Shutters, Arizona. I wanted to talk to you about what type of window coverings there are that can be done in motorization. And the answer is pretty much everything. But there's a difference between some window coverings can do line voltage, where it's like what you'd get out of your outlet. And then there's some that that can only be done in low voltage, like what you'd use to power your laptop or your phone, things like that. Just for your understanding, is most things can be done with low voltage. Like in a blind is going to just tilt. It doesn't lift up, but it does tilt. You can do a cordless lift, but it'll tilt for the motor. Honeycombs, you can do bottom up, top down, bottom up if you want. With honeycombs and blinds both, those can only be done in low voltage. You cannot do a line voltage hard wire on that because the motors are not compatible with that system. So the one thing that we do the line voltage with in particular is roller shades. Roller shades can be done with both low voltage and line voltage, but there's a reason why you might do one or the other. So in particular, if we already are in a house that is already built, the drywall is up, there's no power run to any of the shades in particular, so that we don't have any low voltage wiring, and we're trying to hardwire a shade, the line voltage is usually the best option for that, because we can just take the outlet that's adjacent to the window and we can have an electrician just run an outlet up the wall, and then we can plug the shade in directly there. Then you always have constant power. The line voltage helps us be able to do really large shades. So if you have a window in particular, that, or even a sliding door in particular, that's very, very big and very wide, we can use line voltage for that, because those motors are pretty big and they have a huge capacity. So we're able to make that work and still have it hardwired, even though you don't have the low voltage wiring running to the window. But in a case in the other side of it, if I want to use low voltage, then basically you want to contact us early, figure out what kind of wiring you need, figure out how much wiring you need. We do that in relation to which window covering you're going to pick. In that case, you can have it run through the attic or the ceiling, and those wires run from the window, like right behind here, up into the corner. So behind the shade, but in the corner here, you'd run it up all the way up through the ceiling and into the central location. That's something, if you do that ahead of time and you do it the right way, it's really sleek, really nice. The motors are really great. In Lutron's case, we actually have high capacity with Lutron, where we can still do large shades, but do it in low voltage. And in many cases, especially for hard wiring, the motors are usually a lot quieter than if you did a rechargeable or battery powered shade. You're gonna not even notice that the shades are working in most cases, because they're just super quiet. So yeah, so that's great. As far as shutters go, I'll have to amend my statement that I made before, is that shutters, you can motorize shutters, but they can only be battery powered. So they can be rechargeable. You can't run wires to a shutter, because then you wouldn't be able to open it. It'd be really difficult. So we can motorize it, but only the tilt, and it's not gonna be hardwired. So over here, you've got different shades. Like we've got our Roman shades and natural shades. Those, we only do low voltage wiring for those. There's different voltages depending on which window covering that you're doing. Keep that in mind in regards to which wire you're going to be using. This shade here, this is called a pirouette. This one can be hardwired with low voltage as well. And that one can be lifted, but it also squeezes open and closed. So you can see how that can open and close with the motorization. So instead of having the wand, you'd have a remote to operate it. So, and then over here, we've got the, this is called the perfect shear. We also have the silhouette, both of those, as well as the banded shade. All three of those can be operated with low voltage motorization too. If you have lines run, or if you're planning on running lines, any of these options can be run with low voltage. With drapery, we are able to do line voltage on drapery. But usually what we do is we'll mount the motor right behind the last fold. We can hide it there, even though the motor is pretty big, but we can hide it there. You're not able to see it unless you're doing a shear shade. a sheared material. And usually we'll plug it into an outlet down behind the panel of some kind. So we can do that, but we can also strip that wire and hardwire it in if we had to. Usually for warranty, you usually want to have it plugged in because then it's easy to just unplug it and fix it if we had to, and then plug it back in and let it work. Really, you don't want to involve an electrician just to have warranty work done on any of these items. So the best thing to do, especially with line voltage, you want to have an outlet usually to be able to plug in, because it's just better and we don't have to involve additional parties in order to get it fixed. So that's it.